Hey folks, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to our horror park build here in Jurassic World Evolution 2. In the last video, we finally moved away from the park itself. There was a bit of a catastrophe. The Spinosaurus exhibit has broken open. It's out there somewhere in the park. We don't quite know where quite yet. And then we worked on our compy maze with the shipping containers and all that kind of jazz, this whole area over here. I've had a little bit of a thought. Somebody suggested, I can't remember who, I apologize, that a cool idea would be to have a lagoon with a lot of water nearby, kind of suggesting it's sprung a leak. And I've kind of run with that. I've got a bit of an idea in my head. And we're still sort of in the backstaging sort of area. Maybe this is a, you know, before they send the Mosasaurus or the Plesiosaurus or whatever to the rest of the park, this is where they would breed them in the first place. This is where they would raise them until they're ready to be showcased to the public. So I've got a little bit of an idea in that regard. And then, because I kind of want to build up a little bit more to the hybrid section, so that's what we're going to do today. Now, those of you who saw my mod spotlight video a couple of days ago will remember a particular mod we did that replaced the Mementosaurus. And you'll also remember that we have a Mementosaurus in this park. And so this was not the intention. I kind of forgot that I had the mod installed. I mean, if you want to talk horror, this is as horrific as it gets. They've kind of fused together into some mongers amalgam. It's a Mementi Mongosaurus, suppose. I don't know what it is. It's terrifying either way, so not much we can do about that right now. That's I'll clear out the mod before the next video. Let's put it that way. I really need to sort that out. Also, though, speaking of mods, hopefully I've got this working now. Chiodenix damage tool. This is going to be a big deal. Let's have a little look. We're going to build a big. Oh, I've also got the so I've installed a couple of new mods. We've got the damage tool, hopefully working. We've been talking about that one for a while. People keep suggesting I should have my dinosaurs break out, and that's how I would damage the fence. The problem with that, of course, is that all my dinosaurs will then break out, and I can't be bothered tranquilizing all the dinosaurs. What do you think? I'm made of time? So what we should be able to do instead, hopefully, hit B and then control. Yeah, there we go. That's what we wanted. I actually didn't know they had a staggered damage kind of thing like that, you know, where when as the fence gets more damage. But there we go, a proper breakout. It actually looks like the dinosaur has broken out now, which is really, really cool. I'm gonna move that. I've got a slightly different idea. So this is still very much the plan. You're gonna walk forward. Maybe there's gonna be like a little section. You walk into a new section, like a new level. You walk around one side. Okay, yeah, I've got it. Got it in my mind. Got it in my mind. I can see it in my mind's eye. That's gonna sit there. You're gonna, the left area, we're gonna block it off. So you get to walk around the top. And you get to see what's ever in there, right? Maybe we'll put a Elasmosaurus in there. We'll put something in there. I don't know what it's going to be. And then as you walk around, you get to this bit over here. And this would be where the sort of the sunk down section is. Because I really like that idea. And then we'll put the water here so it looks like it's flooding in the area, is the idea. And that can go over there. And then we'll figure out a way to kind of smooth that out into the next bit. That's fine. And then we need to smooth that out as well. So you can imagine this would be just a natural part of the build, and it'd be like a maintenance sort of bit, I suppose. And what we can do, actually, what we can do is block this off with the hatchery. That's for the aviary. Block this off with the hatchery. There we go. Now sit there. Perfect. Absolutely blim blamming perfect, that is. Incredibly sexy. Okay, we need a big ol' concrete wall. There's too many walls now. It's very confusing for me. Oh, we have new gates. It's an interesting idea, like whether we could use using the Among Us in the distance. Do I still have the so I'm using the expanded. Oh, it's, I know why. This really annoys me, by the way. The fences that you pick are limited to what you've chosen here. So if I go like that and then like that, it'll showcase all of them. Yeah? Yeah. I find that a very strange design choice, personally. I guess it makes sense if you're trying to like stick with a theme. But I think it's probably more annoying than anything else. But, you know, what do I know? Oop. So I don't know. I just wanted this to kind of block off your vision of this a little bit at the start, just to kind of build up some suspense. Or build up a little drama, you know? That is incredibly uneven. I'll just keep putting it in. It'll look fine. No, let's just make that look less stupid. That's a good idea. It's a great idea. Good idea to put down the path first. There we go. Okay, so you're gonna walk forward. And again, we're trying to keep this facility-esque. It's still meant to feel not like a guest area per se. So I'm gonna stick with this, the grey. But you can have it so we can walk right past the edge. This would be like the observation. And then start to drop down here. And then I've got the expanded paths in as well. There's one. Is it the path? Pass-through path? I think so. So the good thing about the pass-through path, I have an itchy face, is that I believe it goes through water, which is obviously perfect for what we're trying to do here. So that's just, it's a shame I can't put the water there. That would be even better, but I'll say it's not meant to be. We could even have maybe something wild in this area. Is that pushing? I don't know, maybe. You know, like a aquatic. I don't want this. Maybe this is where the Spino is. Maybe. I don't know. Oh, no. No. Okay, and then go along there. The problem is the water doesn't go across. Thinking. May not look like it. See, this goes through water anyway, so why do we need to pass through? No idea. If we thicken this up. Got it. Don't worry your pretty little heads about it, right? Daddy's here. No, let's not do that. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull this out to there. We're gonna right, that's why. Okay, yeah. Right. Got it though. Don't worry about it. We're gonna fix that. We're gonna grab our teeny. It's gonna take a while because the pass through path is quite small, but hopefully that works. Yes, there we go. Cryodynamic, you're a god. So we'll build up this utility area like so. And now I need to, I mean, this is gonna be one of those bits I skip forward, I'm pretty sure. But what I'm thinking is we fill this whole area, and then all we do is we block off that immediate left bit. If we put some like crates there and like a crane and kind of suggest that it's broken. And then if you can't quite see it, we can kind of suggest there's a crack in there and that's where the water is. And then you have to walk through the water to progress further. So I'm gonna build out this area with the pass through path, and we'll go from there. Okay, pretty happy with that. I don't think I'm time-lapsing that, but we'll have to see. I was very conscious of, do I do funny things with my face while I'm doing this, or do I just focus? Still not sure. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to block off this side, I think, with the... I want this to be quite claustrophobic in a way, this pathway down. Whoa, had a little twinge there, hello. Come on, Cheeky, there we go. Right, so I really want to match this quite tightly. All the way down, and then it opens up at the bottom. I think having this sort of a lot of horror is about subverting expectations, right? Well, less so these days, kind of the initial idea. So I think having this sort of tight, closed off area that you just can't see much else in. Let's have a look how that's gonna look. Yeah, so you get it's very subtle as well. The hills, as you start to go down, you're like, okay, yeah, we are. I mean, you can't really see any further into there either. This is actually kind of useless. Maybe we'll put a viewing area in there. Well, like a DFW one, right there. And then you're going down and you start to drop and you can't really see what's coming. You know, all you know is you're sinking further and further down. You're like, what's going on here? And then it opens up and you suddenly realize you're going to have to move through the water. And maybe there's a dinosaur in there, or maybe the concern is that it's flooded, there's a pipe burst, and whatever was in the enclosure is now there instead. That might be pushing it a little bit far. Dunno. Let's get rid of some of this grass. that nonsense. No nonsense allowed. We're very serious here, thank you very much. But yeah, I like that. This is nice. This is because I'm kind of just trying to mix things up a little bit. This is very different from what we've been doing. I was very aware that we had a lot of, you know, this is a dinosaur exhibit. The dinosaur has broken out. Oh, hey, here's the dinosaur exhibit. Where's the dinosaur? And I wanted to try and move away from that at least a little bit, you know. Research viewing gallery. I need my Lagoon viewing stand DFW style. There we go. Life is pain. Okay, it doesn't actually have to work. In theory, I can kind of, if it would just stop clicking. Stop! Okay, we're not using that. Gonna be cheeky. I mean, this, you know what? This might not be what it's used for, but I tell you what, I think this could look really cool, actually. And this is the benefit of, like, free building. Why are you jumping over there, by the way? This is, like, the benefit of free build. We can do crazy things that you just couldn't usually do, you know? The world is our proverbial oyster. Right, so we need a path here, obviously. Oh, do we, though? Can we... Yeah, we can. The hatchery's there to make it look realistic, but I don't want to touch it by a path, so we're just going to transport them over. Now, we've already got a Mosasaurus. What do we want in this? What's the spookiest of the aquatics? That's the question, folks. That's the question. It might be Tylosaurus. Tylosaurus has a kind of stupid, it's like an almost cartoonish evilness to it. Leoplerodon is where I'm leaning. I want to use a Carnotaurus, though. Which is more cute, I'd suggest, than anything. Maybe. No. I was going to say, so maybe actually these are, oh, there's not a big enough batch, though. We're going to use Leoplerodon. I want to cram quite a few of them in there, because I think it'll, I don't know, just kind of work for what we're doing here. So we're going to make 5 of them. Just lots. 5 is that many? It's a crazy number. Absolutely crazy. Get my eggs. Maximum egg, as they say. Or as I say. When did I come up with that? Chaos Theory, I think it was. Memenchi, please! You see a Monga's booty just floating nearby. It's terrifying stuff. Right. Boop, 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 boop. And they need food. Now, you say you're not going to work, but does that mean you're actually not going to work? Could put it there. No, No, because that ruins my beautiful thing. It's where stuff like this, I don't know, am I crazy? I swear free build used to be less limited. I'm not having a pop here. Free build is a beautiful, beautiful thing that everyone should use. But I think it's more limited than it used to be. I think maybe a change in the patch, you know, has kind of changed how much it can realistically do when update 2 came out. Right. This hill is going to be a little bit of a problem. We need to block that off with a big old wall. The solution and cause of all of life's problems. Big walls. Too many boundaries in our lives. Boop. Okay, and you come along there. Beautiful stuff. We could even stay downhill. I don't know where we're going to go after this. Really, haven't really thought that far ahead. And let's try to... If there's one thing free build is always beautiful for, it's pathing more than anything else. Just being able to fill that path there, something obviously we wouldn't be able to do usually, is immensely helpful. I'm going to grab this. This is a weird one because we're probably not going to quite finish this in this video because it's a strange build. I'd like some, not advice, but I'd like to know what you guys think and, you know, where would you guys take it after this? That doesn't really matter. You're never going to see that. But that's the general gist of what I was going for. It's going to be a little bit too heavy on the concrete for my liking. It needs opening up somehow. Maybe this. I've got to think, because this is not meant to be an aquatic habitat, right? It is meant to be a normal backstaging research area for the aquatics, for the marines, and it's flooded. That's what's meant to have happened, more than it being an aquatic place. So it has to kind of maintain that feeling. Tell you what, can't seem to get rid of the grass. Let's just... Yeah, there we go. Lovely, 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 lovely. Okay, cool. Right. We'll patch this. I mean, I think that's actually a really nice idea. It's a really good viewing area. Quite tough with that, actually. God bless you, free build. There just wasn't any other way I was going to do it. There are people in it, which is kind of annoying. Can I deactivate? Be gone, people. Thank you. People shouldn't be here, you know? But yeah, it works. It hangs over the edge. It looks a little awkward, but I look a little awkward, so that's fine, you know? Who am I to judge, really? Right. Okay, let me have a little think. Let's do another one of these up here. Down there. Okay. And some trees. Along with some big bushy trees. I do need to install. There's one more mod I want. It's probably the last one I actually want to install, but Cowdenic, again, just assume it's Cowdenic who makes the mods I'm talking about. Has done a wonderful foliage mod, which adds like 600 plus foliage options to the game. Which is a lot, by the way. It's kind of a crazy number of foliage, so it gives you a lot more. Again, it's just about options, right? About being able to have that creative control. I really like how this looks, though. Quite happy with this. I'm going to put pylons running down the side. They don't have to connect or anything. That's stupid. Oh, curve pylons. I just realized this. Why would you be able to curve a wire? Yeah, that wouldn't make any sense. Never mind. What I love is to be able to have, like, an effect. You know, have, like a little zippy-zappy-zoppy effect. Official terms, by the way. A little zippy-zappy-zoppy effect right there to suggest that, you know, pylons or the electricity or something's like landed in the water. Although saying that, well, we can't have the effect. We could put a backup generator in there. I'm trying to think what the idea I just got was, if we can make this a little bit more like a video game. In that, you know, so many video games have like an electrified water section that you've got to get through. I don't think there's a decoration. What I would want is a decoration that we can put in the water that you have to move between. That you have to basically have to walk like a really thin path through these decorations to get through the water. I don't think we've got a decoration that's going to work for it, unfortunately. How deep are these? Yeah, I mean, they're just full on floating, aren't they? Yeah, it's going to be a problem, actually. Is the building floating? No. So the buildings we can... Ooh, the building is float. Is the... the building is floating slightly, yeah. This is... Okay, so we can't break that, which is a shame. But I think the concept's really cool, but it needs just a little something. This area needs blocking off a little bit more. So viewing area. Let's just see what it feels like. I do like this. I think that's a really cool idea, the swooping down. And I think that works to an extent. You know, you'd have to use your brain a little bit, but there's a lagoon, there's a flood, there's a smashed up bit here. Yeah, I don't know how I'd ever do that. I don't think I can do that, but maybe. No, they're not going to sink down enough. And you carry on around. I will fix that before the next video. And you follow the flames of guidance. You head off to the next section. It needs some detail work. It needs, like, maybe another idea to tie it all together. I'm not sure what that is, so I'm gonna leave it with you folks at home. Thank you very much for joining me. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Hopefully it's worked, more importantly. And I can see myself in a little screen at the top. It's very disconcerting, actually. Although I'm having a good hair day. I cut my own hair these days. Like, I've cut my own hair for the last, like, 3 years now. And I've gotten really good at it. Kind of proud. I'm gonna tab out, but it is gonna break things. Bear with me. Okay, where are we? Okay, so thanks for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love, and as always, bye-bye. This is a little bonus edition. I realized we didn't really spend any time at all with the Leo Pleurodons, and I think that's silly, so I'm just gonna chuck in some Leo gameplay at the end, I suppose. See our Leo Pleurodons doing their thing. They've got the right kind of vibe, the right kind of aesthetic, I think, for, you know, where it feels like maybe our company, I don't know what company is, Biosyn, Masrani, InGen, whatever you want to call them. It feels like the kind of strange creature they would experiment with in secret. You know, this is not something ready for the public. It's a bizarre, mutated, very exceptionally spiky creature. It's something a little bit special, something a little bit weird. And it makes sense that you'd kind of... God, this one's even got... I've got bioluminescence installed for so many creatures still. I need to do a proper wipe of the game at some point. It feels like the kind of thing they would hide away at the back, you know? What I'm thinking in the last few seconds as well is there's no reason... So we've got the wall here, but there's no reason, even though this is flooded, that this couldn't have been something else on the right-hand side, right? This area here could have been something else. It doesn't have to be shut off like this. And then the whole area is flooded. So maybe there could be another research bit here or something, like a dinosaur habitat. We could even have a dinosaur here. And... have their exhibit be flooded with water and maybe have some crates and stuff floating in their exhibit as they walk around and just flood, because we don't need to worry about their food and stuff. We could flood the entire dino habitat with water, which I think might look really cool. We just bring that out, swap that to a different type of fence, probably move the generator out of the way, build some other stuff and kind of build that into an exhibit like that. I really like that idea. I don't know what dinosaur that would be, so feel free to throw some suggestions down below and I'll work on that before the next video and showcase it for you guys. And I think that'll... I'm going to redo this area here, basically, but I think that'll make the whole area feel a lot more interesting. And you'll be forced to kind of, like, by this blockage here, be forced to, like, walk next to this flooded dino habitat with kind of creaking fences and stuff like that before you head off into the rest of it. Yeah? Yeah, that's a good idea. I'm genius. All right, cool. Once again, thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.